In this video, I'm going to show you guys my must-visit scenic spots in Kyoto. So you might have already seen my top 10 things to do in Kyoto video, as well as top 10 street food. But in this video, I wanted to focus more on the picturesque side of Kyoto. And DJI has been kind enough to send me the DJI Osmo Pocket. So for the rest of this video, we'll be filming it on this light-size, gimbal-stabilized camera. And since this video isn't a sponsored video, help support my channel and check out my Tokyo merch. Or if you want to see what I'm doing on the daily, then definitely check out my Instagram account. Alright, so let me show you some of the most beautiful spots in Kyoto.
Number 8. Kamigawa. We're starting at one of Kyoto's most scenic spots, Kamigawa. Locals have referred to it in the past as Blue Dragon or the River Where the Gods Live. During the Edo period, Kyoto became a gorgeous geisha quarter and the locals often spent time at Kamigawa, cooling off at the restaurants and bars on the river and shallows. There used to be about 400 shops back in the day, but were taken away due to levee works and are now being slowly rebuilt since the Showa period. Pontecho Street runs parallel to the river and you can see many of its restaurants extended towards the river with temporary terraces called Seiryo Toko. The river itself is also a perfect afternoon spot in the spring and summer months to have a picnic or a cold beer with friends. Number 7. Kyute Omuro. Now this is one of my secret Kyoto spots that not a lot of people know about, as it's tucked away in a little Kyoto neighborhood. This house was built in 1937 and it showcases traditional Chaya-style Japanese architecture, Sukiya Zukuri. The house opens up into a stunning garden and its beauty is reflected on this large wooden table. During the summer months, you'll notice the garden lush in green leaves, but definitely worth visiting in the autumn months to capture the changing leaves of deep reds, orange, and purples. Recently, the house has been turned into a rental space, perfect for tea ceremonies and wedding dinners. I'll leave a link in the description if you're interested. Also, compared to other Kyoto tourist spots, this house is fairly quiet. So if you ever make it out here, let me know by taking a picture and tagging me on Instagram. Number 6. Yasaka Koshindo. This spot reminds me of a gumball machine, but in fact it's a Koshin temple located just below Yasaka no To. The bright colorful balls are called Kukuri Zaru, which are good luck charms. It's supposed to represent a monkey with bound feet and hands. It represents the control of playful and desire-driven creature that everyone possesses inside of them. It's believed that if you sacrifice one desire, a wish is granted. Hence, by writing your desire on one of the colored balls, it removes that desire and your wish comes true. Number 5. Ninenzaka. If it's your first time in Kyoto, then I definitely recommend visiting this scenic spot. Littered with shops, cobblestone streets, and machias, it definitely has that old school Kyoto vibe. Ninenzaka is the hill leading towards Kiyomizu Temple, and it's definitely an Instagram spot, especially from the top overlooking all the wooden buildings and the towering Yasaka no To. Like much of these spots, I definitely recommend coming early in the morning to avoid the crowds. Trust me, you'll appreciate so much more. Number 4. Keiage Incline. Keiage Incline is a 582-meter long slope with railroad tracks. It was originally built in 1890 for moving equipment and boats, restored in 1977, and later designated as a National Historical Site in 1996. I really enjoyed this place as it's a comforting release from Kyoto tourist masses. And if you're ever in Kyoto during cherry blossom season, this spot will not disappoint as it's lined with cherry blossom trees. Number 3. Kinkakuji. So what's better than a temple? How about a temple coated in gold? This unique spot is one of Japan's most visited buildings. Kinkakuji literally means Temple of the Golden Pavilion. This three-story building dates back to 1397 and it burnt down twice, but the last time in 1950 by a 22-year-old monk. Ashamed by what he did, he later attempted suicide on the hill behind the building, but failed. The building was later rebuilt in 1955, but the gold leaf coating wasn't applied until 1987. Number 2. Hanami Koji. Hanami Koji is a famously known area for spotting real deal geishas. They are commonly seen strolling in the evenings, but I've seen a few in the early mornings as well. The area itself was originally owned by the Kenjinji Temple at the southern end of the street. In 1871, the land was reclaimed by the Japanese government, but was later purchased in 1874 by a private group called Gion Kobu Ochaya. This group owned and ran many geisha tea houses during that time and transformed the area into a hanamachi, or as what we know today as a Gion Red Light District, running north south, you'll find a healthy mix of merchant homes, tea houses, restaurants, bars, and even some high fashion brands, all discreetly hidden behind the machiya style facade. Some of the tea houses have even more than a 300-year-old history, serving samurai warriors and politicians alike. But I highly recommend veering off the main street as it gets quite busy and venture into the back streets to get a better sense of this historic place. And number 1. Arashiyama Bamboo Grove. So this video wouldn't be complete if I didn't include this spot. It kind of speaks for itself. So I guess I'm gonna shut up now and let the video do the talking.
Alright, so there you have it. Links to each spot as well as a downloadable link for the map. And yes, I know I didn't include Inari Shrine, but I already did a video on it. So if you want to see that, then definitely check out my top 10 things to do in Kyoto video. Again, if you want to help support the channel, then definitely check out my Tokyo merch. And if you guys want to see what I'm doing on the daily, then definitely check out my Instagram account. And if you want to see more of my Japan guides, then definitely hit that subscribe button. I release a video every Saturday morning, 9 AM Japan time. And thanks again to DJI for sending me the Osmo Pocket. Oh, and something worth mentioning, DJI is running a UGC competition the month of June on their Instagram account. Although I didn't use the story mode in the video, this is how it looks like. It's the best way to submit your entry for the competition. The theme is summer vacation, so definitely get creative. Make sure to tag DJI Global and hashtag MyPocketStory. And you can check out more information on their Instagram account at DJI Global. That all said, catch you guys in the next one.